We talked about harmony in the society. Now we'll talk about harmony in the nature. So at the level of nature, you know, we have to further explore certain things. So far we have explored our natural acceptance, and we could see that our natural acceptance is for living in harmony as an individual, as a family, as a society. But at the same time, it remains questionable whether something that is naturally acceptable to me, is there also a provision in the nature to live accordingly? So is there provision in the nature or existence for living in accordance with our natural acceptance? Is it really possible to live in harmony as an individual, as a family, as a society? Now, when we come across such notions like the struggle for survival and whether the fittest can survive, right? Then we tend to assume that the nature is designed by way of opposition, by way of struggle, by way of, you know, survival of the fittest, right? So there are some doubts and queries inside us. So we'll explore into this further. So we'll see whether the very design of nature is by way of coexistence and mutual fulfillment or something otherwise, right? So when you look at the nature, we can see there are so many things in the nature: air, water, trees, soil, you know, birds, earth, moon, sun, metals, non-metals, right? We are also there as human beings. And when you talk about human being, the self is there as well as our body is there, the human body is there. When animals are there, you know, and when you say animals, we'll understand how animal also is a coexistence of self and body. So the animal body is there, you know, where the self is also there. So how to understand all these units? So one way could be, these all units can be categorized into four orders. So one order could be physical order. So physical order would mean soil, metal, non-metal. Like if you look at the building, you know, this building is a unit of physical order. The bricks, the walls, the roof, you know. If you look at the chair, table, laptop, mobile, all these things are, you know, units of physical order. Then we have this bio order, where we have plants and trees. And we can make out a difference between the physical order and the bio order, right? This bio order grows. The physical order does not grow. You know? It remains as it is. For example, if you make a building, it remains at its own height. But if you plant a small sapling, it grows into a tree, right? So we can see that plants and trees are somewhat different from physical order. Like their natural characteristic is somewhat different. Their innateness is somewhat different. Then we can also see that there's another order, which is called as animal order, where we have animals and birds. You know? And we can also see that the animals and birds are somewhat different from bio order and physical order, right? When we have this 8-day workshop, we study all these orders in detail, but briefly we'll go over this. And here we are as a human order, right? So between physical order and bio order, we can see that there is a relationship of mutual fulfillment. There is some interconnectedness, there is some interdependence, right? And when you say mutual fulfillment, it means that there is cyclicality there, and in that cyclicality, every unit is getting enriched. For example, the soil is there and the plant grows on the soil. The plant takes its nutrients from the soil, sheds its leaves back to the soil, and the soil becomes more fertile. Wherever we have a plant, the water table comes up, you know, goes higher. So this plant is enriching the physical order, and the physical order is nurturing the bio order. So there is a relationship of mutual fulfillment. So when you see mutual fulfillment, we can see that they are related as well as they are mutually fulfilling. They are fulfilling. So if you look at the Hindi word paraspar purakta, where we have parasparta, that is, there is a relatedness there, and also there is a purakta, there is a fulfillment there. And we can see a cycle is there. The plant grows from the physical order, goes back to the physical order. So the plant grows from the soil and goes back to the soil, isn't it? So, and in that process, every unit is getting enriched also. So we can see this kind of fulfillment is there between physical order and bio order. When you look at the animal order, a similar kind of thing is to be observed. So the animal, the herbivorous animals are taking, you know, their food from the bio order. Right? So the bio order is nurturing the animal order, and their fecal matter goes back to the soil. So the physical order gets enriched, right? And through the physical order, again, the bio order gets enriched. So we can see how animals are fulfilling to the bio orders as well as the physical order, you know? Even the carnivorous animals, if you see, they are surviving on the herbivorous animals many a times. And there also a similar thing can be observed. with the physical order as well as the bio order, right? So we can see that among the three orders, there is a relation of mutual fulfillment. So there is a cyclicality. If you look at a forest, we have these three orders existing in the forest. In the forest, the physical order is there, the bio order is there, and the animal order is there. And it will never happen that a deer will eat so much of grass, you know, that there will be no grass left, right? And then the soil will become barren. Or the grass will grow to such an extent that the trees will be depleted. It will never happen. So this will never happen that the forest will get depleted by virtue of animals. In fact, if you look at the forest, it remains so green by itself. Now, if you look at the human being, what we are doing, we are depleting all these three orders. The physical order, bio order, animal order are enriching for us. But human order, that is we, without right understanding, we are not fulfilling any of the four orders. So there's a question mark everywhere. We can see that water is getting dried up. So many rivers have dried up, right? We are depleting the soil. So much of land has become barren. The air is getting polluted. Just now, there was a news 2 days back that this time, the heat wave is not going to be that much. In fact, in this season, in this month of May also, the summer has not come to the point where it used to come the previous year. So the heat wave is going to be less. So what we are doing, we are warming the whole earth. We are depleting the soil, we are depleting the air, we are depleting the water, and we are depleting this physical order. In a similar manner, we have done so much of deforestation, right? The forest coverage is going down day by day. And just now we saw that there was fire in the Amazon basin, right? That Amazon forest. And there are also some fire in the forest of Australia. So we can see that we are depleting this bio order also. Similarly, we are killing so many animals. I just read that Royal Bengal tigers, in 1901, they were around 50,000 in number. And today, if you see, the count is even less than 3,000. So by killing those animals, we have depleted some, some varieties of animals also. So we can see that we are not fulfilling to these three orders. And ultimately, who is suffering? We are suffering. Like going by the notion that is coming that this coronavirus has spread through some wrong kind of food. We can see that with such a long history of our mankind, we are not able to understand what is food, where to take the food from. And in that process, we are not only depleting these three orders, but rather we are also suffering. And whenever we suffer, we have a need for more and more money. We have a need for more and more physical facility. Like 20 years back, if you see, arrows were not to be seen in the houses. The water was pure and used to drink the water that used to come from the land itself. But now we have to purify it every time. And we have to install these RO systems. And when you go to install the RO systems, you have to pay for it. So every month, every year, you are going to pay some amount for it. So what is happening by depleting these three orders, we are indirectly raising our need for money, our need for physical facility. Presently, when there was pollution in the month of October and November last year, then air purifiers were on sale. So ROs have become quite a common scene in the families today. Now, air purifiers are also being sold, right? So now you have to go and purchase air purifier. Then again, you have to pay for it. Tomorrow, let us say, if the ozone layer gets depleted, then you will have to have a shield upon yourself every moment. And then you have to purchase a shield also. Now, what will happen to our health? What will happen to our relationships? In this lockdown, we are not able to meet each other, greet each other, isn't it? So this kind of problem is arising. So let us take some reflection from you. So what is naturally acceptable to you? To be mutually fulfilling for all the four orders, or to dominate, exploit the other three orders? And in our living, are we mutually fulfilling? So one choice could be yes, we are. The other choice could be no, we are not. So reflect upon it. You know, before responding, just reflect upon it. What we are doing today. In the meantime, I can take few reflections or few questions. So Dr. Paul Raj.
Very good afternoon, sir. This is Dr. Paul Raj.
Yes, sir.
Human order can fulfilling physical order through preparing our soil using some ureas and other things.
Mm-hmm.
The bio order we can fulfill through our tree sapling. And for animal order, we can fulfill caring of our pet animal. Mm-hmm. So in such a way that we can fulfill all the three orders.
Yeah, but I am saying that in place of using urea, we can have a better way of producing manure.
Yeah, yeah.
In fact, when you use urea, the topsoil gets depleted and you have to use more urea every year. So the amount of urea that you have to use in cultivation goes on rising every year.
Yes, yes.
So we can have a better alternative to it.
Yeah, we can use
people are talking about natural farming, people are talking about organic farming.
Organic,
yes, kinds of practices can be evolved.
Yes, sir. Natural organics.
Yeah. In a similar way, we have to see how can we fulfill to the animal order.
We can see
after we are locked down in our houses, the animals are roaming free.
Caring a pet animal.
No, I'm not saying make them pet. This is not the right way to make the animals pets. The right way would be to provide them natural habitat. You can just see when we are locked in our houses, you know, the sparrows are chirping outside.
Yes, yes.
And animals are roaming around.
Water, food, we can provide water.
Yeah, we have invaded into their natural habitat. So, yes, of course, we need some land to live. But at the same time, we have to see how we can ensure their sustenance also.
Yes, sir.
And that is something that we are not doing.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
So, of course, we are able to see that the natural acceptance is to be mutually fulfilling. But in our living, Anna, if you look at it, many of you are saying that, yes, we are fulfilling. But again, we have to observe. If that was the case, then we would not have been locked up in our houses, isn't it? Or we did not go for air purifiers. Or we not be suffering from cancer out of faulty agricultural practices. So this is something that we have to observe for ourselves. Nice. So human beings have natural acceptance to be mutually fulfilling, you know. And once human beings understand, they can be fulfilling for all the four orders. So once we have this right understanding, we can be more fulfilling than these three orders. They are already fulfilling, but if you want to compensate also for the loss that we have done, you know, we can be much more fulfilling. There's a person who has written a book called, there's a man for whom a book has been written, The Man Who Planted Trees. And in that book, it is mentioned that this person by himself planted trees in 30 square kilometers. So you can see, unknowingly, we are deforesting, you know, we are removing the trees, you know, felling the trees. But once we have the right understanding, we can be so much fulfilling to the bio order. You know, we can plant so many trees. We can help the animals grow in such a beautiful manner, right? We can replete the soil. We can replete the air. You know? And unknowingly, in the name of modernity or development, we are extracting so much of mineral resources. And it is also going to become one of the reasons for war between nations, because many of the nations which are called developed have depleted the resources, the mineral resources in their land. And now they are trying to extract the mineral resources from beneath the ocean. And the ocean belongs to no nation. So there might be war if you do not, you know, act on it correctly. So we have to see how much metal and non-metal do we really need in our life. You know, otherwise, we'll keep on depleting the nature just as it is. So we can develop such technologies. With right understanding, we can develop technologies so that we can fulfill our needs through mutually fulfilling processes. So for example, many of the things that we are using made up of metal can be replaced by wood. We can always grow plants extract wood, you know, and then fulfill your need. It is said that one human being in lifetime on an average consumes 4 big trees. Now just think how many plants we can plant which can grow into big trees. So at least 10 big trees can be grown by us, and we need only 4 big trees. So once we have the right understanding, we can be so much of fulfilling to the rest of the nature. Let me take another viewpoint from you. The problems we see around us today, like deforestation and atmospheric CO2 levels beyond 410 ppm, so many things, melting of glacial ice, global warming and climate change, are these the natural problems? Science already has clear understanding of the nature, or these are unintended man-made problems showing lack of understanding on the part of human being. And it is essential to understand the harmony in nature and refine what is taught. So kindly reflect on this. What is the state today? In the meantime, I can take one question. Dr. Nisar. Dr. Pumalar. Okay, Dr. Umarani. I think people raise hands, but when we are not able to call their names at that moment, they forget. Fine. Okay, Dr. Uma Maheshwari.
Sir, good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon,
ma'am. So it's a wonderful session on society, harmony in society, and also by nature. So here we have one issue now, sir. That ozone layer was had a hole, but now they say it is, does not have. So it means it is only by human, right? It all because of human only. Now we have settled in lockdown, and so there is no pollution, and hence
certainly, ma'am, certainly. These are all man-made problems and unintended. We never wanted to have landed up into this kind of situation, ma'am.
Okay, so we have to now correct ourselves in working with all the nature and society also to come out with a good excellence, right?
Certainly, ma'am, certainly.
So what are the steps that we can take, sir? That is the thing. So one thing is we have to write from our society, means from the individual, from whom it has to come, is it not?
So there are so many things that we can do. First of all, we have to look into the program that we have made to fulfill our need for food, growth and shelter.
Okay. So
if you look at the cities today, you know, they are getting populated so much. So high-rise buildings. You know? On one part of the land, we have so many buildings, so many people living, you know, in one place. And there is some place which is deserted. The villages are becoming deserted. You know?
Okay. Yeah.
So can we have some program where we can have equitable distribution on this earth? So why, in the name of prosperity, you know, with a precondition that richness is prosperity, people are flogging to the cities, trying to, you know, spend their whole life in cities, and then we have a dearth of resources in the cities, and then we are exploiting the villages, trying to bring every resource to the city, and so much of tussle is also going on. So why not have a living model where we can fulfill our physical needs coexisting with nature?
Yeah, that is how we can spread this to the villages and also rural areas. So
we
that
also have to look for ourselves, ma'am. How we can, you know, have a kind of mutually fulfilling living for ourselves.
For ourselves, yes. Mutual fulfilling for ourselves will be.
We are suffering. We do not have pure water to drink. We do not have fresh vegetable to eat. We do not have, you know, insecticide, pesticide free food to eat. So ultimately, we are suffering. Cancer has become a common disease in the houses, isn't it, ma'am?
It was a very rare and chronic disease. Now it has become common.
You look in the neighborhood, in the 3 generations, at least one generation has this kind of disease.
Exactly. So
ultimately, we are suffering if you are not understanding the nature.
Correct. But how we have to make it, we have to implement, sir. It's not only designing, planning.
Certainly, ma'am.
We have to implement. So that it is coming to the society in a good form. So that at least by another 10 years or the next generation, we are again purified. It is purified, right?
Yeah. So like few things I can mention what we can do right now. And we can also look at the complete paradigm, complete model of right living. So like in your colleges, Hannah, You can have water harvesting programs. We can have solar panels so that we do not depend on coal for electricity.
Yes. Yes.
We can utilize the electricity rightly. We can save the water. Right. Those many measures can, of course, be taken in the family as well as in the institution.
Our PhD College of Technology, already we have this solar panel for about 750 kV.
Right, ma'am. Right. So these measures are to be taken.
Yes.
We can such houses, and architecture has a big role to play there, so that we do not need air conditioners. See, there is so much of energy outside in terms of sun, and we are using air conditioner inside. Why not make the house in such a way that the heat outside can be utilized to cool the room inside?
Okay. Fine. Exactly. So
We have to think of such techniques.
Techniques, technologies, again, but implementing.
Certainly, ma'am. We have to work in terms of mutually fulfilling technologies.
Okay. Okay, sir. Thank you. Mutually fulfilling only we have to do.
Yes, yes. So that can be one takeaway from what we are discussing right now. So nice, we are able to see that these are unintended man-made problems, and we have to, of course, look at the solution. Now, if you look at the four orders of nature, we can see that in the physical order, there is only activity of recognizing and fulfilling, right? So if you look at a metal, it combines with another metal, and at some given temperature and pressure. So that is only a case of recognizing and fulfilling. In the bio order also, if you see, there is only activity of recognizing and fulfilling, and the plant grows by virtue of recognizing and fulfilling. But when you look at the animal order, there is also an activity of assuming. For example, you bring a small puppy to the house and name him Tommy, right? And you keep on saying Tommy again and again, and the puppy starts assuming that there's some relation of this word Tommy to me. So that assumption is there. You bring a plant in your house and name it Tommy and see what kind of response you get. And you bring a puppy in your house and name it Tommy, and then you can see what kind of response you get. So there's a difference between the response of a plant and an animal. Why so? Because an animal, if you see, has an activity of assuming also. And why is that happening? Because there is a self also there, and a body is also there. So if you look at the animal is coexistence of self and body. Here we do not have any self in the plant. Here we do not have any self in the physical order. If you look at the human order, we have the activity of assuming, recognizing, and fulfilling. In addition, we have this potential for knowing something that we are working for, right? And we have a self and body. So I am a self, I am coexisting with the body, right? Similar case with the animal. And this presence of self is indicated by the presence of activity of assuming. So this is something that we have got to understand, all the four orders. To understand the other three orders, right understanding of the human order is required. Otherwise, over-evaluation, under-evaluation, otherwise evaluation of the other orders keeps on taking place. Now, when you do not understand the nature as it is, then these are two major problems that we face. One is the resource depletion and the other is pollution. So resource depletion means that the resource is used at a rate which is faster than the rate at which it is produced in the nature. So for example, we have extracted coal, we have extracted petroleum, so many things we have extracted. And they are not being produced at the same rate. So we have depletion of these resources. And the second problem that you see is pollution. So pollution means the product is such that it does not return to the cycle in nature, or it is produced at a rate that is faster than the rate at which it can return to the cycle in nature. So for example, if you convert uranium-238 into uranium-236 in a nuclear reactor, it will never go back to uranium-238. So this is an acyclic process. The other case which is mentioned below is like production of plastic. Now the plastic takes on an average about 10 years to decompose. And we are producing plastic at such a high rate. This single-use plastic, which is being also discouraged in the society. If you do not understand this, then we are going to create a big plastic pollution. Similarly, the pollution in the air, the pollution in the water, you can see the recycling that is taking place in the nature is much slower than the rate at which we are adding the pollutants. So let me take another opinion from you. So to be mutually fulfilling, we have to understand mutual fulfillment in nature, or we just have to do what we have to do to survive. Kindly reflect on this. Yeah, there are some hands raised, but what we can do, there's some limitation of time. So we can discuss the questions after we formally close. So nice, you know, we are able to see that we have to understand the mutual fulfillment in the nature. So if you look at the nature, you know, we can see the quantity of units in the nature. So you can see that the physical order is maximum in terms of quantity. So this whole earth, the inside of the earth is physical order. You know, the top layer is also the physical order. And on the top soil, the plants are growing. So the quantity of plants is much less than the soil or the inner part of the earth, right, in terms of mass. And there also in the forest, we can find animals in some places. So the number of animals is far less than the number of plants. And our number is certainly much less than the number of animals. So if you look at the quantity of units in each order, right, it is in this way. The physical order is the maximum, then the plant order, then the animal order, then the human order. And you can see that the quantity is as per the overall enrichment of the whole and availability of the sustaining resources. Right. And we can also see that our sustenance is dependent on all these three orders. So, for example, a plant is dependent on physical order. You know, if the physical order is depleted, plant will not grow. If the soil is barren, the plant will not grow. The animal order has to depend on plant order as well as physical order. And our existence is dependent on all these three orders, animal order as well as plant order as well as physical order. So the survival of human order is dependent on all the three orders. Let me ask another question from you. Do I see that my survival is dependent on the other three orders? And can I do something to nurture the other three orders being in my job? Try to think over it. You know, we keep on looking at problems which are there outside in the nature, in the society. But can we do something about it? And here we have a role to play as technocrats and as educators. We have a big role to play. What we can do being in this job, you know, to fulfill the other three orders. So nice. So we are able to see that our dependence is there on the three orders. And we can certainly do so many things, right? We can certainly do. So all orders have definite conduct except human order without right understanding. In the human being, the body has a definite conduct. The self operating on assuming without knowing is the source of indefiniteness problem. So the only problem on this whole earth is the self, which is assuming without knowing, right? And when the assumption is based on knowing that we have the right understanding, right, then we are in a state of resolution. So the solution is to ensure knowing, that is to understand harmony. And human beings inherently have a natural acceptance to know, to be in harmony. And for this, education sanskar is an essential program. The good thing is that we all are involved in education program and we have a big role to play here. So whatever we discuss, ultimately we are able to see that it is going to be ensured, the resolution is going to come, the solution is going to come only through education, right kind of education. If the right kind of education is not there in the family, then ultimately it has to be there in the schools and colleges. So that the children who pass out from our schools and colleges become, you know, responsible parents of tomorrow, and they can give that kind of sanskar in the family. So again, for self-reflection, I'll just ask you to reflect on this. Mention any five programs each that you can make to ensure the mutual fulfillment with the nature. So just start thinking what you can do as an individual, what you can do as an organization, what you can do as a part of society. Can you do something in your colony, in your neighborhood? Something that you can do in your institution? Something that you can do at a personal level? And additionally, there is a video, An Inconvenient Truth. The vice president of US was there, Al Gore, and he has made this video. And it reflects on the problems that are cropping up in the nature and how we have depleted the resources over the past 100 years. So some statistics are also provided there. So to sum up, we have these four orders in the nature: physical order, bio order, animal order, and human order, right? And there's a relationship of mutual fulfillment, that is harmony, among these four orders. The first three orders are mutually fulfilling for each other. They are fulfilling for human beings also. It is naturally acceptable to human beings to be fulfilling for all the three orders, right? Rather, four orders. The role of human beings is to realize this mutual fulfillment. And for this, all that we have to do is to understand that mutual fulfillment, that is harmony, is inherent in the nature. You do not have to create it, right? And we just have to live accordingly. So you do not have to create this harmony in the nature. It is already there. You know? The orders are already mutually fulfilling. We only have to understand and decide our role, isn't it? And there's every provision in the nature for living with mutual fulfillment, that is harmony. So this is all that I had to say right now. We can take some reflections from you. So if there is any reflection regarding this, you can take up. Maybe I can take one question.